So this one I'm working up as a boat neck sweater. Of course, you could have a round neck if you want. This part doesn't really matter that much. What does matter on the front and back is marking where the sleeves are going to go. Now, I do have these little things that I will use for marking, but you could just take a contrast and color yarn. Take your latch tool, put it through the loop on the end needle, and pull it through. And just let that sit there. This was row 28. I did hand knit the rib. So now I need to work 84 more rows to row counter 112, and then do the boat neck ribbon, which of course I'm going to do by hand, but if you're going to do a machine, just do your favorite way of doing ribbon. If you want to do a round neck, you could do that as well. Basically, the sleeves are going to be changed a little bit, and then it's a matter of marking the ends of the front and back where to place the sleeves on. Now the pattern, I have it working from the cuff up to the top of the sleeve, which would mean I would have to sew that in place. So I'm going to reverse this. I should have done that on the paper, but I could do it here while I am sitting looking at it. But it does tell me that I have 140 stitches to end with. Now, I could probably even go the extra 10 stitches, but I'm going to leave it at this. Now, for this machine, I do have to put my cast on comb off, but I have to remove these little markers. They get in the way. The yarn part will not. I could leave it there. And then to be on the safe side, I'm going to hang some claw weights. I may take these two claw weights, put them up on the end after a while. Okay, so now it tells me to, well, I got to decrease, but it says increase one stitch every end, every row once, then every second row 47 times. To 140 stitches. So I got to reverse that. So I got to go every second row 47 times. So 47 times 2 is 80, 94. So I'm going to end up with row 94. I'm not sure how many stitches I'm going to have because I'm going to be decreasing. Decreasing is easier than increasing. So I have my carriage ready to go. So it was 2 rows. So let's see, I want to leave a little bit on the beginning here so that I have enough to sew up that little seam just in case the beginning yarn is not enough to go up. So now the way I like to decrease is to take the 2 or 3 end needles and move them one in. I'm going to do 3, and I'm going to do the easy one. Now if I want a certain look, I could take the 4th stitch, move it to the 3rd needle, move those 3 needles in. But the easy way is just to take the end 3 needles, stitches off those needles, move them one in, so now the 3rd needle has 2 stitches on them. Push that empty needle back. So again, I'm doing this every 2 rows until row 94. I should have marked that. Then after that, I'm going to be doing every row. Oh, wait a minute. No, it's one stitch each end every row once. Okay, yeah. Then every second row 47 times. So after this, I will do it after the 47th time. I will do one more, which is one row. And then I have to make sure I'm to 96 rows at the end. And then after that, I just do my ribbon, which is going to be 44 stitches and 14 rows. But let me zoom in so you can see what I'm doing here. So I take the end three stitches off of those needles, and I just move them one end. So now needle three from each end has two stitches on it. Push the empty needle back, knit two rows. So I just did my last decrease, row 94. I knit one row, 95, and then I'm supposed to do another decrease. But because I am hand knitting the rib, I want to have an odd number of stitches. So I'm only decreasing on one side. It's up to you. Well, even to do a machine knit rib, I would still want to have an odd number. Having one stitch off is not going to hurt the pattern or the finished item. So, of course, I knit across. And on to my final 96 rows. Now, if you were to continue this in rib, whether it's on, well, it's on a plastic machine with no ribber, I would knit 14 more rows. And, well, 13 more rows at tension dial 2, and then one row at probably tension dial 6 or 7. And then I would undo those last 14 rows, relatch up. But I found that tension dial 2 was a little bit too tight for me on this machine and this yarn. So that's why I decided to hand knit. So what I'm going to do is take my hand knitting needle. And actually, I got to take the comb off and the weight off of the material. And then, because I'm right-handed, I am going to go from this side here. Then I'll take my other needle and just switch it around so that I have the yarn at the point of the hand needle. So for me, I am just going to hand rib the last 14 rows and then bind off. Now I will make sure I have a good length of yarn because I will take that yarn and sew up the sleeve seam. And this way here, you don't have a lot of yarn tails to weave in. If you're going to crochet a single crochet latch tool, well, it's actually crochet up the seam, then of course you have to have a little bit more yarn than if you were to plain sew it. After I'm done with this, I'm going to hang the other side, work the other sleeve, sew that one up, weave any yard tail ends in, and then show you the finished item. And there, it's all done. I still need to wash it, possibly steam it where the sleeves meet the body. But this is about as close as I can get to a dolman on this machine.